relay the forecast now with meteorologist Nicola Crosby.
We have a very blustery day on our hands this morning and a little bit of everything just depending on where you are. We have been picking up quite a bit of activity on the radar that makes the rain and snow and sleet. Some areas just seeing heavy rain, some areas seeing snow, and then we've just got some clear skies in some areas of the capital region as well. We can count on the wind today, 30 to 40 kilometers an hour. Daytime highs drop into -5 today. We should see a cloudy afternoon. Temperatures continuing to drop down Thursday morning to -12. Daytime highs tomorrow for Valentine's Day, -5. Mix of sun and cloud and winds 15 kilometers an hour. Finally, we have southwest winds kicking in. Daytime highs pop up to +6. And then Saturday, we've got showers in the forecast. Highs of 3 becoming snow overnight. With your exclusive iNews 880 Weather Watch, for the meteorologist, Nicola Crosby.
Thanks, Nicola. It's really sunny, it is windy, and it's zero right now in Edmonton. It's 10:13. This business update is brought to you by Challenge Insurance, a proud supplier of Intact Insurance and offering home and auto insurance at group rates for teachers throughout Alberta. Visit challengeinsurance.ca. The market update now from the NZ 80 Business Center with Dr. Morrison.
The stock market has only changed amid a slew of earnings news and a retreating oil prices. The S&P/TSX Composite Index edged up 4 points. The dollar's up 4/100 to 99.77 cents U.S. The average Dow Jones Industrials fell 26 points as January retail sales ticked up 0.1% after a 0.5% rise in December. The drop reflected higher payroll taxes and a rise in income tax for top wage earners that went into effect in the new year. The NASDAQ was 16 points higher. Analysts think the overall tepid performance on markets reflects rising caution as a March 1st deadline looms that would see steep automatic government spending cuts take effect to the tune of $85 billion. Such a cut would take a big bite out of U.S. economic growth. Oil's down 15 cents to $97.36 a barrel. Talisman Energy shares gained 2% after posting disappointing operating results as it took a hit from continually low natural gas prices and reduced output, but offset that with gains from the sale of assets and tax items. Canadian Press, I'm Malcolm Morrison.
Thanks, Malcolm. While making news with our commuters east of the city, dealing with some winter weather driving conditions, Morinville RCMP warning drivers that icy road conditions and poor visibility on Highway 2 south of Laguiel. RCMP members right now dealing with two semi-trucks that are jackknifed and blocking traffic on Township Road 572 on Highway 2. After 10, the latest now from Edmonton's Four Theater, 630 Chen, here's Brian Hall.
So the Oilers lose 4-1 last night to carry less than 35 saves, and the Dallas Stars have now won 4 straight. And the Oilers had lost 6 of 7, and they had scored only 14 goals in their last 8 games. It was the opening game of a 5-game home stand. But the Oilers, with the problem of scoring, it now puts added pressure on every player because those who are expected to score, Ryan Nugent-Hopkins as an example, you start gripping the stick a little tighter. You start pressing. You therefore make mistakes. Sometimes the shot's there for you to take and you don't take it. One more move, I've got to make sure this is going to go in. And it's not a good situation to be in. So there's some very important practice time coming up for the Oilers over the next few days before they play their second game of this homestand, which is Saturday night, 8 o'clock at Rexall against the Colorado Avalanche. Roberto Luongo, 25 saves, the Vancouver Canucks beat Minnesota Wild 2-1. Canucks have won 6 in a row. And Luongo has lowered his goals against average to 1.45, second only to Ottawa's Craig Anderson, who had 42 saves last night. The Ottawa Senators beat the Buffalo Sabres 2-0. Victor Pfaff making a couple of stops in the shootout to remain perfect in 6 starts. And in the matchup of the top 2 teams in the Western Conference, the Anaheim Ducks beat Chicago Blackhawks 2-2. Philadelphia Flyers, who lost the night before against the Leafs, beat the Winnipeg Jets by a score of 3-2. And stopping all 3 shots in the shootout, Carey Price of the Canadiens was there for them. They rebounded after blowing a 3-goal lead and beat Tampa Bay Lightning 4-3. While a goal in overtime from Colin Wilson gave the Nashville Predators a 1-0 win over the San Jose Sharks, who have lost now 6 straight after opening the season with 7 consecutive wins. And the New York Rangers recovered after blowing a 3-goal third period lead in a shootout, knocked off Boston Bruins by a score of 4-3. and the Florida Panthers lost 6-5 to the Washington Capitals. And the Carolina Hurricanes beat the Jersey Devils by a score of 4-2, snapping a 5-game win streak by the Devils. 10 games last night, and the Columbus Blue Jackets fired general manager Scott Housen, while Toronto Maple Leaf goaltender James Reimer is expected to be sidelined at least a week with a strained knee ligament. Better look after everything for now. More sport coming up next half hour. I News 880, this is fine.
Thanks, Coach. I News 880,
10:17. You know, we're going to make a morning houses right here in Edmonton. It's the one of the amazing opportunities. We're looking for a small group of older individuals owning our real estate assessment team. We'll learn our simple two-step system for flipping homes.
Hi, my name is Sam Merrill. I'm a star of TV show Flip This House.
My team and I are looking for a handful of people in the Edmonton area who want to learn how to consistently make a lot of money, earning it in your spare time without using any of their own money. Edmonton is a perfect market. My system and this team have only a free 2-hour educational workshop where you can learn how to make a lot of money flipping houses.
You heard it. Sam's workshop is happening right here. This week over. Don't miss your last chance to get 2 free tickets. Time is running out, so call right now to get your 2 free tickets at 1-800-262-8090. That's 1-800-262-8090. 1-800-262-8090. The news you want, when you want it. This is iNews 880, Edmonton's only all-news radio station.
Good morning, I'm Kim Smith. There's word that a Wallace with Christopher Doner's driver's license has been found in the rubble of the cabin that was the scene of a shootout and fire east of Los Angeles. The charred body was also found inside the border. Tammy Abdullah says police believe the remains are those of a former police officer who was wanted for shooting rampage.
The body itself will have to go through a forensic examination to positively identify it as Christopher Dorner's body, but this driver's license was found in a wallet along with the body in the basement.
Two sheriff's deputies were shot during yesterday's siege, one fatally. Dorner is also suspected of killing a young couple and a police officer. Well, disabled Carnival cruise ship in the Gulf of Mexico is still a day away from reaching shore. Florida Mass government claims what will happen once the Triumph is towed into the port in Alabama.
Thousands of passengers are going to be triaged by medical personnel. Then they'll be passed on to 20 charter flights and flown home. That's after having spent 5 full days aboard a ship with little power, almost no food, and very little sanitation.
The ship has had limited services since fire in the engine room on Sunday. Well, the Vatican says Pope Benedict will spend his final day as pontiff attending a morning farewell ceremony with cardinals then fly off in the early evening to his summer residence. That means that Benedict will not be too hot in the Vatican when he ceases being pope at 8 p.m. on February 28th. I need the 8, I'm 1020.
As a major supplier of new, rebuilt, and quality refurbished generator sets, industrial engines, oil field equipment, and Holman light towers to light up your job, Global Power Systems has been serving Edmonton and area for over 25 years. With generator sets ranging from 20 to 2,000 kilowatts, plus a complete line of Caterpillar engines ready to go, Global Power Systems is your independent diesel engine specialist. For experienced and honest industrial engine service, a complete repair facility and parts department, or to review the full line of equipment.